think that the values that underline the phone network apply just as much as we move to the next generation of communication services and broadband. I think that how those rules look may be a little different than what we've done in the phone network because it's a different technology and it operates differently. But at the end of the day, we still want everybody to have access to what the basic service is. And as that moves to broadband, then we need to make sure that we still have rules that are ensuring everybody has access to that too.
Ms. Griffin, in notes on your testimony, it sounds like you're not necessarily believing the broadband companies have an incentive to make sure that, you know, the majority of the calls go through and that you really think government has to, is that your position? Do you really need government to force broadband providers to make sure that their service is excellent?
I think that we have seen some reports where there have been failures, like cases in rural call completion. And the lesson I take there is that even in situations where there may not be any bad actors, new technologies can create situations where nobody really has an incentive to absolutely guarantee that call goes through. And then
do you think government can absolutely guarantee that every call goes through? Do you think government really has got a better capability as opposed to the broadband carriers themselves to provide excellent customers? Let's face it, if you have a company you're providing a service, if it doesn't work very often, don't you think customers are going to switch to a different company? Don't you think competition would actually do a far better job than having the heavy hand of government try and guarantee that, which I don't think it would do?
Well, I think in too many areas, competition doesn't exist or isn't robust enough to really guarantee that people are going to have a meaningful choice, particularly, say, if they're using a heart monitor and they may be able to switch to a wireless service, but it wouldn't support the heart monitor or something like that, or if the new service isn't affordable. So I think that, you know, the essential promise of the phone network is that when you make a call, it goes through. And that should be the goal of the government, is to make sure that we're fulfilling that promise.